TikTok.
So talk about growing up. Like, did you have, like, did you grow up in a one parent home, two parent home?
Nah, I really grew up in a one parent home. My grandma raised me, bro. So I really grew up without my parent, kind of. Really, like, Jimmy and my brother, we just getting out the mud for real. So, you know. But, you know, as you get older, you realize shit that shit just be rough coming up for real. Especially when you got, like, I don't got no kid myself, but when you got a kid, you feel me, that shit rough. So I learned a lot from being around a lot of niggas and shit. Being around a lot of people, not even niggas, just people, period. And just going a lot of different places. I learned that it be rough coming up, and, you know, everybody got excuses. Really can't make no excuse for it. So, shit, I just be one of them niggas who make excuses for everything. Shit, I had to realize anybody gonna get it to me, but I didn't get it.
Yeah. So, with you and your brother, like, what, were you the oldest, or were you the oldest, you the younger?
I'm next to the oldest. Basically, I got an older brother. Okay. Really, like, I got a little younger brother. Everybody else younger than me.
Yeah.
This shit, I damn near feel like the oldest. Take care of everybody. I'm helping everybody out, you know?
Yeah. What, like, growing up, like what was it like being, like, middle child and shit?
Shit. You know, I just say, you know, growing up, having an older sibling, like older brother, you know, you grow up wanting to be like a lot of people. You know, you got a lot of role models and shit, but that shit don't play out. You always gotta find your own lane, you feel me? No matter who you feel like this your role model, you look up to them, you still gotta eventually branch off and do your own shit, you feel me? So I had to learn that, really. Even as young, I always been alone, been by myself. I don't need nobody with me. Me and my stick. I'm good.
Yeah.
For real.
So, like, growing up, like, how would the people describe, like Kilo as, like, a student, like, in school coming up?
Oh, yeah, coming up, everybody know I was in school, like, I ain't gonna say I was no goofy-ass nigga, but I just play a lot. I was sport, I was athletic, so everybody know me for sport.
Yeah.
And really just doing my work. I'm getting, I knock my work out, and when it's time after that, I'm turned up.
Yeah.
But I really be chilling though. For the most part, everybody know I'm laid back. I don't talk much. I don't fuck with a lot of people. I don't even really like people like that. They just be chilling.
Yeah.
But I'm still social. I'm real social. I like to network.
Yeah. So like, when did you, like, you said at 13 start doing tattoos? Was that like your first, like, entrepreneurship? Like, that was your first business?
Yeah, honestly. But then just being out here.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, niggas stealing. I ain't gonna lie. Everybody used to steal and shit. I was young before I used to steal. No, nothing major, but like little petty shit.
Yeah.
Hand licks and shit. Came up on a lot of shit, but that shit wasn't worth it.
Yeah.
Really? I mean, that really was my first hustle. Like, after I used to draw. I used to draw stuff and paint. So before that, I did used to paint and do self-portraits. But before that, it was just like trapping in the street. Then I got picked up a tattoo gun. And it was like, I ain't got to do this no more. Just straight tap. I made too much money out of tattoo. Then it's something I like to do. So then, like, nigga making me go to work and do this shit. I had to get up. Or I could stay up all night, do tap. And I didn't go to sleep. 3-4 days straight.
Yeah.
I done made more than nigga made in a whole month.
Yeah.
Shit like that. So.
Fair. So let's talk about the tat, man. Like you done did 2 out of the 3 I got, you know what I'm saying? So up until this point, you know what I'm saying? How old you at now?
I just turned 23.
You just turned 23, so you 10 years on the gun. How many tattoos you think you done?
Did too many.
Yeah.
Too many.
Yeah.
Ain't no number. Over 1,000, I know for a fact.
Yeah. I done
tatted so many people.
Yeah.
I done tatted celebrities, all kind of shit, so, you know.
What's your favorite tattoo story?
favorite tattoo story?
Yeah.
I ain't really got none, I ain't gonna lie. My life's so exotic right now.
Yeah.
Shit be crazy, shit be really damn near unread. Yeah. Some crazy shit be going on out here.
Yeah.
But I ain't got no crazy shit, just like out the wild shit, just like my mold probably big tattoo moment just popped up somewhere. I probably did 2 tat, ended up doing 10, why not that be a cover rack? So like damn. And then I met a lot of people and shit, so that was like just a good experience for me. Even though I came down for something else, you feel?
Yeah.
So, probably one of my big little tat experience.
Fat.
Sit back, make back, call the curtain. She want a purse, want a Birkin. Nigga be rapping and acting and snitching and bitching and with one you working. Work, work, perk, perk. I got this bitch.